Motors, your source for Falcon, Fairlane, full-size, Mustang, Maverick, Pinto, Ford truck, Cougar. Contact us at www.autocrafters.com.
Okay, so we figured it up and we have 138 spot welds to fill on this floor pan, but you do want the spot weld spaced about an inch to an inch and a half apart when you're putting one of these together. It's just going to help with the structural rigidity of the cabin itself. Another thing you're going to want to do is, in my opinion, get one of these, because this sucker right here, this air punch flanging tool, saves you a ton of time because you're not having to go in and do a hand punch on every one of these spots and then try to find the dent and then try to drill it out. This sets your first hole and then you can go from there. You'll notice that we've cut a divot into this because originally this thing was not that deep. This notch that's here was not originally on this. So we cut a notch in there a little deeper using a Dremel tool, and we also used a cutoff wheel to make that work a little bit better so it'd get deeper into the flange so that we're more centered up and not blowing the edges out of this floor pan every time we're doing a spot. So if you get one of these, they're pretty inexpensive. You can get them at Harbor Freight. Sometimes you can find them online pretty inexpensively as well. It is well worth it when you're doing one of these. If you were trying to do 138 spot weld setups on this, you would go mad. The next thing I'm going to talk about what we used is our step drill bit. Now, you don't have to use a step drill bit. You can use a standard drill bit of an appropriate size for whatever size you feel comfortable with doing your holes. We had a piece of tape on here initially, but Logan, you know, he kind of ran it out, so we don't have that. But last thing is, you're going to want one of these because this sucker, when it starts drilling, throws, you know, stuff everywhere. You get these online. That's where we got this one. So there you go. That's all of our tools and stuff. And now the procrastination is over. So now all we got to do is V this thing up and throw it inside of the Ranchero. I've talked to a couple of different people. There's a couple of guys that talked about two or three different ways to do this. The way that seems to fit to me with us in the position we're in with the suspension being on the Ranchero is to go in through the bed again. But I am going to V the floor pan with some straps. And hopefully that'll help us get enough width in there that we can duck the tunnel front piece in and make this thing fit in the hole. Theoretically. I may go in the other direction after we try to do this and it doesn't work. All right, I'm going to V the pan. We're going to use some ratcheting straps. That's the only kind I would use for doing this. Otherwise, it's just not going to work. The pull straps are not going to be able to be tensioned up enough to make this fly the way you want it to. So what I'm going to do is send one half for the back over to Logan.
Is it still going to be?
It'll be. Sure. That's that one. And then the bigger hole up front. I was hoping to put that in some holes that A, don't matter, and B, are not these major plug holes, but alas, one other thing that didn't go quite as planned. Fly! Well, if them let go.
I like scaring children.
Okay, it's V. Now let's take these straps and make them safe by putting them in here. That's good. You don't like this? I don't like it either, but I can't figure another way to do it, so just throw them in there. Now we're going to pick it up and put it over into the bed of the Ranchero. Well, we V'd it once. It looks like we're going to have to V it twice. I'm going to take, and we've already ratcheted this one more time. It's starting to pull these holes. Now, this nice thing is, these are just holes where the plugs would go. They're actually, I guess, you would call them scuppers for if the car gets wet inside, maybe. I don't know. So I'm going to V this one a little more in the back. I keep squinting because I'm worried that at some point these things are going to explode off of here. Logan just walked out. Bunch of chickens. Trust me, if that strap hits you, no eye protection is going to help you from that. All right, now we're going to try to flip this thing in. already better than before.
Can we get down there?
We're gonna need to skewer Logan again. Well, I don't know if we'll get it back out, but it is sailing in. The problem we may have is on the inside, and we're gonna reset so we can take a look at what we've got going in the car. We've got the floor pan is actually contacting on the two corners. The lips are contacting it, so we're gonna have to move those in somehow in order to get this thing to go in deeper before things are done here. All right, now what I've done is I've tied our strapping off so that it doesn't fold up underneath here when we're moving the pan into position. I'm not necessarily putting this in here for final right now. We're just seeing if this plan is going to work. So far, it looks pretty good. I've gotten this side to clear where we're underneath the lip of the back wall. Our biggest struggle now is going to be getting this lip for the front seat brace pulled through and then making the arc up in order to get the pan over the hump here. We may have to take this brace out of the car. I don't know. You're going to have to get over on that side. Logan, right there. There you go. Oh, whoa. Yeah, it didn't cut any fortune.
Yep.
All right, I think now that we got our gloves on, I think that we're probably going to have to take our brace out. Let's see, once we try to go that way, it's going to have to. Let's do this. Let's go forward. It's going to be right there, it's going to be where it would be. Yeah, we're going to have to cut the brace out. All right, so we're going to cut the brace out off camera. No need to show you how to do that. And then we're going to come back in and it might work it with our welds. We're gonna have to come back in and then try to get the pan to roll up and lay where we want it to. Teenagers, phones, silence is golden, except for teenagers. It's not golden for them. Anyway, gonna go find the Dremel tool. Is where we may run into trouble because the wheel well is biting us. The wheel wells are biting us. We can't get far enough forward for the wheel well.
We just gotta lift it up because it's gonna wear. We just gotta lift it up.
No, the problem we're running into is that the wheel wells back here are stopping the pan. Yeah, well, the torque boxes are a problem, but also the wheel wells are a problem. Because people have said, here's the thing, is people have told me that you could go in and put the pan up underneath and move it forward and then put it up into position, but with your frame in position, you can't. The pan in the back here on the wheel wells is not happy. The only thing I can see that we might be able to do, we may have to go in and cut this upper section out of here so that we can get it to pop in over the top and just cut to the bottom or even a little bit lower across here. The big problem is the closeness of the wheel wells on the Ranchero to the back wall. Every time I look at this, it's like I think, you know, it may be a case where we need to just cut the wall higher up. Cut more of the firewall, the rear wall out. We tried going in through the windshield. It's not wide enough. The other plans that we've talked about, they don't work. The only thing that's going to work probably is this because it gives us more room for it to clear the wheel wells in the back to get it up toward the front. I didn't really want to do that. Had I done that initially, had I made this cut first and cut the wall out, I would have been okay with it. It would have been less of an issue in my mind. But now we're not just going to have to fix the welds down here where you can't see them, but we're going to have to fix welds up where you can. And that's going to require a lot better welding than I'm probably capable of. So I may make Robert come down here and do this. Hey, Robert, if you're watching, you may be up here pretty soon. And we'll probably go back in and do another small episode on this, on how we set everything up and after we get the pan in. But what I wanted to show you this week was just what we go through to get the pan in here. This is what happened. All right, Logan. Well, it's kind of in here. We're still lifting in the air for right now. Okay, so that tells you right there that to get the pan in a Ranchero, you are going to have to go and make those mods. If you have a hard top, you can go in through the side. A sedan is going to have the same kind of issues that we're having with the Ranchero, and it's going to actually be worse on a sedan two-door because you have the post here, and you have no way to come in through the back really all that easily. The only thing you could possibly do is to take the cross braces out in the back area, but how are you going to get it past the trunk? So you may end up having to do what some of the other guys are saying, take the braces out, slide it up into the back as far as you can, lift it up and pull it in toward the front. I'm going to release these clamps. The nice thing is we can always put them back. Okay, so I'm gonna come on your side.
To your lower, we gotta like be level.
Yeah, I'm actually sitting in, I'm in position. I mean, the driver's side pan is where it needs to be sitting. So I'm gonna have to come in on the passenger side and muck around. Unless you think we're ready to weld this thing into the car, we're not. We do have a few more miles to go before we can actually weld everything in. Now I'm going to mark up my tunnel for position with exactly what's going on underneath here. And all I'm doing right now is just going in and marking it up so I'll know where to put my cuts in the actual floor itself. And where all my problems are, I'll actually lay this floor pan out upside down. In other words, I'll put it with the tunnel section right here will be laying up so I can know where I'm going to be making my cuts. So that's all I'm going to be doing here is just going through and marking up the floor for the other stuff that needs to be cut. Yay, team. And we're going to go all the way into the back as well. I'm not going to show you that, but we're going to go all the way up into here in the back section so we'll know exactly where to make our cuts on that. Oh, gosh. Well, dude, you have had a first. You have put your first floor pan in.
This too.
Yeah. Well, yeah, it is me too. This is probably one of the hardest things you're ever going to do on a car, dude. You have accomplished a great thing. Toe boards are tough, but this is like the worst. And in this particular chassis is probably the worst. Now, we still got to go in this U to weld in some spot welds.
Oh, yes.
But But I mean, we'll go in, we're going to do another episode, one last episode on this. And what we're going to do is we're going to give you guys some tips and tricks on how to weld one of these things in, some of the things you can use to get a good tight seal between the floor pan and the frame rail so that you've got a nice solid weld and you've got metal sandwiched to metal. This is a really nice floor pan. I got to say that I've messed with other floor pan materials and this is a nice, solid, thick, heavy-duty steel. This is a good floor pan. I am very impressed with what we've got here. If you're going to buy one of these, without a doubt, I would say go ahead and do it. If you have a Ranchero, go ahead and cut the back wall because that's what we had to do. All right, folks, do me a favor. Leave a comment in the section below. Let us know what you think about what we're doing here. Give us a thumbs up. Give us a thumbs down. It's entirely up to you. Also, do us another favor and go check out our Patreon account. Our Patreon account, at the $10 a month level, you get monthly meetings with me, and we sit down and discuss all kind of crazy stuff. We have Stump the Chump, where I answer tech questions from the guys that go on there, and we are doing a bunch of cool stuff. In theory, I am planning on bringing in some special guests for us to have, Mike Eaton from Eaton Detroit Spring, people like that coming on to the Patreon account to sit down and have one-on-one conversations with you guys that are in the group. Well, not one on ten, but you know what I mean. Also, do me another favor and go out and subscribe to the channel. We are looking for 100,000 subscribers by Christmas. I am now beginning to agree with my cameraman that says we're never going to make it just simply because we're only at 68,000 right now and the rate of increase and blah, blah, blah. My analytics guy, Bill Rodishan from Six Round Studios, says probably not going to happen. Unless something miraculous happens. We have a Christmas miracle. That'd be great. In any case, folks, do us a favor. Come back and watch next time, and we'll see you on down the road. Like he said. Only very, very quietly.
On down the road.
Good boy. Let's go get some dinner, man.
Yes.
Ants in my pants. I have ants. I got ants. Fire ants in my pants. Seriously.
It's rolling.
And audio's rolling.
Kind
of like that right up near my man parts. It's not going to itch in my pants.
Action.
Oh, you clapped already.